Good morning, everyone. It is Monday, September 30th, and it's been 2 weeks since I've actually sat here to talk to you, and a lot has changed in 2 weeks. As you know, we started off on Friday the 13th on our two-week road trip to the Wild West Court Reporter Convention and the Wild West Roundup. In Breckenridge, Colorado, we drove across the country. We actually rented a car because all of our cars are like 20 years old, and so we rented a car and just loaded up and started driving. Ended up in at Shiloh National Historic Park, Battlefield, and several other national parks along the way. Went to Taos, New Mexico and explored. It's a lovely town, although I can tell you that right now it's under construction. The main drag is a one-way street and the road is torn up and it's kind of messy, and I feel kind of bad for the people that live and work there because it's got to be very difficult for the tourism. And then we drove up to Breckenridge, had a wonderful 3 days there, got there Thursday evening, then Friday, then Saturday, and then we left on Sunday. Got to meet new people, got to do my presentations, got excited to share about voice and advocacy, but also about the cat was knocking something over. And then we drove home. Now, driving home was a lot less leisurely than driving out. We spent most of the way out not driving on the interstate. On the way back, we spent most of the time on the interstate so that we could get home in time for the Pumpkin Festival, which was to be this past weekend. However, as most of you know, Hurricane Helene was in everyone's sights, and we were in Kentucky before we left for the last bit of the drive on Thursday, and we were trying to beat the storm home. It was the only day that we had to drive in the rain, and we cut across the mountains, y'all. If you have seen any of the devastation, we drove through areas right before stuff started closing down. We usually take US Highway 58 through Damascus, Virginia, up and over and then down. But as I was looking at the map on Google Maps, I was seeing that it was already congested. And I thought, okay, well, let's go the other way. So we took Virginia 91 along a creek that was under a severe weather advisory, a flood warning. But we did it. We left Damascus, and it was one of those places for us that we wanted to go to. And we had planned to do the Virginia Creeper Trail. It's a downhill and visit for like a two-day weekend and just explore. And then we made it to Mountain City, Tennessee, another little town that we've been to. Great little coffee shop there. They're also along the river. And it wasn't really raining that bad. It was still not pleasant to drive, but it wasn't like super bad. And then we got to Boone, North Carolina, cutting across on Highway 421, and we made it to Boone, and Boone is a quaint little town. I've done work there many times. And then we got home. On Friday morning, they canceled the Pumpkin Festival because we had a lot of flooding overnight downtown, and it just wasn't safe. We had actually turned in our car on Friday. We had to drive back to Wilkesboro, and the Yadkin River was getting very high. The bridges, many of the bridges across the river to the other side of the counties were being closed as they were starting to be encroached upon. And so, no surprise, they canceled the festival. So we got home in time. The weather here was really rainy and windy. We did lose power for a short amount of time, not much at all, like flickers, not even. We were very fortunate. But when we woke up on Saturday, of course, we saw the devastation, Friday as well, of the towns that we had just been through. And our beautiful mountains are destroyed. Our little towns, our favorite places, people are stranded. They have been caught in flood stage. This storm was bigger than Katrina down in the Gulf. And if you think about it, you know, these are areas that don't get this kind of rainfall. So you can be prepared, but you can't be prepared for a flash flood with waters rushing by and, you know, flood stages over 20 feet. Just water moves too fast, and it's almost impossible to stay safe if you're that close to it. Little towns just destroyed. Kids stuck at school at Appalachian, at Cully, at Western. So really, really dangerous. People without power. There were landslides, roads absolutely in and out of like Asheville. You couldn't for 2 days. No power. The water took down the cell service. You know, took down the power lines, took down the cell towers, took down everything that would allow people to get to and from. So unless you actually had the equipment there, you couldn't clear out. Many people's cars are flooded or gone. Houses gone, destroyed. I actually saw a video with a trailer just obliterated. Nothing to it but pieces. So the cleanup is going to take not days, not weeks, not months. It's going to take years, y'all. North Carolina, southwestern Virginia, eastern Tennessee, and even parts of North Georgia and northwestern South Carolina will never be the same. And please keep everyone in your prayers. I'm trying to work. My head is definitely not in the right place to do it. I was going to be driving to the board meeting in Atlanta this weekend, but because of the status of the roads and my concern about sinkholes and just traffic in general, I'm going to now be flying. So I'll be flying to Atlanta for the NVRA board meeting on Friday and coming home on Sunday. But hopefully here in my little area of North Carolina, things will stay calm and life will try to find a semblance of balance and order. I am working. I've got deadlines. I've got committee work. I've got board work. I've got plans for the next several weeks. And I hope everyone, if you are in a place of safety, that you can stay there. If you are in some way affected by this catastrophe, that you have had a way to get to a place where you can be warm and safe and have found your loved ones. There are many, many groups out there doing outreach and donations. I know Samaritan's Purse, which is here in Wilkesboro, just, you know, down the road from us, is one of those. I believe on my Facebook page I did post a list of links. Thank you for all your kindness. Keep us in your prayers. North Carolina is never going to be the same. And I'm going to get to work now. Have a good week.